dyscalculia is often diagnosed when children struggle in school, when they struggle with addition, subtraction, basic math concepts. Underlying dyscalculia is a basic lack of understanding quantities. That's at least what we think right now. That's what the research literature suggests. So what does that look like? So a child with developmental dyscalculia might, for example, struggle comparing which of two numbers is larger or which of two arrays of dots or objects is larger. So they have difficulties discriminating quantities. They're slower at making judgments of relative quantity than typically developing children. So for example, if I show you a group of six apples and three oranges, and I ask you which group of fruit contains more fruit, children with developmental dyscalculia would find that more difficult than children without developmental dyscalculia. They might also struggle when number is represented spatially. So when you use a number line, let's say you have a number line from 0 to 10, and you ask the child to put a hatch mark where the 8 is. Children with dyscalculia may greatly struggle in representing quantity spatially. Difficulties in understanding quantity and also the links between quantity and symbols lies at the heart of dyscalculia. What do I mean by links between symbols and quantity? What I mean by that is if I show you an array of 5 dots and then show you the numeral 7 and the numeral 5, and I ask you which of these numerals represents the set of dots, children with developmental dyscalculia would struggle to give the correct answer. And that is because they have a poor understanding of the link between symbols and quantities. But it can go deeper than that. Children with dyscalculia may also have difficulties understanding the relationships between symbols. So they may have difficulties understanding the rank order of a symbol or the relationship between symbols. So for example, if you show a child with developmental dyscalculia a group of 5 oranges, and then you show them the number word 5 and the number word 9, and you ask them which number word connects to that set, children with developmental dyscalculia might struggle to give you that answer quickly and efficiently. And then you can imagine how these difficulties with quantity and making the links between symbols and quantity eventually lead to difficulties in learning how to add and subtract. Because when you add, you need to activate the quantities associated with the numbers that you're adding together. If I, for example, show you 3 numbers, 1, 2, 3, and ask you, are these in order or not? It's a very simple question, but children with dyscalculia often struggle with things that assess their understanding of the order of numbers as well. Deficits in quantity processing is a major hallmark of developmental dyscalculia.